Hi guys, welcome to Marine ETO channel. So today I'm going to tell you guys how we can easily understand the electrical power system layout of a ship. How we can read a single line diagram, of course. So whenever you go on board, especially in ECR, you can see a lot of manuals for machineries, for electrical. There are a lot of electrical drawings, and out of these electrical drawings, you will get a single line power distribution diagram, which is very important because this is the actually Bible in which you will get all the details of the electrical power systems, and you can easily understand how each machineries are connected, how each machineries are interconnected, how the power is flowing to different machineries. So we will get a total outline of how our electrical systems are connected. It's very important when you go on board. Within few days of joining, you must check this power distribution diagram. So you will get a clear idea about how each things are connected. Okay. So right now I am showing you guys how the single line electrical power distribution diagram of my ship. So you can see that this is my ship is a DP vessel, and we are using DP2 configuration. And later on in my videos, I will tell you what is this DP and DP2 configuration and all. So here we have split bus configuration, and hopefully I think you guys know what are bus bars for our pressure. Electrical carriers, your bus bars are nothing. It's like a metallic bars which is used to carry high current distribution. Okay, so here you can see this is bus bar 1A. This is my 440 bus bar, and this is 440 bus bar 2. And there's 220 volt bus bars, 220 bus bar 4. And this is ESB, emergency switch board bus bars, and 440 ESB. So in our ship, we use our voltage is 440 volt. Our generators are producing 440 volt at the frequency rate of 60 hertz. So we can just start from the sources. Okay. So these are our generators. Generator 1, generator 2, 3, 4. We have total 4 main generators, and along with that we got emergency generator, which is of a lower power rating. You can identify the power here. It is 1800 kilowatt for 4 generators, and this is only 150 kilowatt. And from here also you can identify what is our voltage generated by the generator. This is 440 volt at 60 hertz. So you can see that this is a breaker. Okay, later on I will take you guys to the engine control room and physically shows you guys what are, how these breakers are connected to the bus. So we'll get a better idea. So this generator number 1, this is a symbol of the generator number 1, and this is connected to this breaker, and is connected to the bus bar ring. Suppose this generator is started, and it started developing 440 volts, and this 440 volt is coming to this breaker, and after our command, we close the breaker, and you can see this, the power will go to the 440 volt bus bar 1A. And same like here, if we start generator number 3 or number 4, we will get 440 voltage at bus bar 2B. So these are the producer sections. Okay, obviously the name itself, they are generators. Okay, so who are consumers? So you can see that from this bus bar, it is connected to various DB. DB is distribution board. It's like DB1, DB5, DB6. In this DB, there are a lot of breakers which are connected to different consumers. So this 440 volt, which is produced by the generator, is consumed by all these consumers in the panel. Okay. And this is MCC. This is a motor control center. There are a lot of various motors connected in this motor control center. And now we can see the biggest consumers. Okay, the 2000 kilowatt. So this 2000, it is azimuth thruster. This is used for our propulsion. This is an electric propulsion ship. And we have both thrusters. We have two both thrusters, and we have two azimuth propellers. And you can see that this side is always similar to this bus bar 2B. There is no difference. And you can see a middle This is the inter breaker, okay? This is a circuit breaker which is used to split these two bus bar. So suppose if we are not in a DP system and we need only one generator for our all consumers, that time we can close this breaker and we can switch off any of two, three generators, and we can use one generator to supply the power to all our consumers if our consumers are very less, okay? So again, whenever you are sailing, so that time you need to switch on both the generators in both sides. Okay, so you can now you understood what is a 440 bus bar A and 440 bus bar B. So now the next thing is that in a vessel, you don't have only 440 volt consumers. Obviously, we have lighting loads, too many lighting loads. So and like at our home, the lighting loads are all of 230 volt. So how we get a 230 volt from a 440 volt bus bar? Right, for that we use step-down transformers. So this is a step-down transformer symbol, and we are using 120 kilovolt ampere transformers, and at a time maybe only one transformer we'll be using. If it's a DP2 configuration, we will put off this breaker and both transformers will be online. Okay, so this 440 volt coming from bus bar is stepped down to 220 volt, and it goes to the bus bar 3, and from the bus bar 2B, this 440 volt is stepped down and it's going to the bus bar 4. Again, similar to the 440 volt bus bars, 220 volt bus bar also splitted into two because we are following DP2 configuration. Okay, so again from the 220 volt, this is connected to various load. Like for our UPS, there are two UPS which is taking load from this bus bar, and there are a lot of battery charges. There are a lot of 230 volt DBs. Okay, similar to that, again in the same case in bus bar from also there are a lot of consumers, 230 volt consumers. Okay, now we are going back to the 440 volt switchboard. See, here you can see a line which is going straight down to the emergency switchboard, bus bar 1. Why is it coming from directly 440 volt? Because this emergency switchboard 440 is getting directly supplied from 440 volt bus bar 2B. Okay, so in normal conditions, when there is no emergency, there are consumers in our emergency switchboard 440 volt bus bar also, like our watertight doors, watertight door motor, there are main air compressor. In out of the two main air compressor, one is connected to this emergency switchboard. So in case of any emergency, we can start that main, after starting emergency, this emergency generator, and we can start that main air compressor. Okay. Like that, a few items, very important items or critical items are connected with this emergency switchboard. So when there is no emergency, we always put off this emergency generator. We don't not need this. In normal cases, what we do is we will take power to this emergency switchboard from our main 440 volt switchboard. From that, we connect a breaker here. I will physically show you where these breakers are located, so you will get a better idea. So in normal cases, we will close this breaker and we will close this breaker. So power will start flowing from here to this 440 volt bus bar, and it will give supply to the consumers. Okay, and similar to what I said before, there are 230 volt emergency consumers also, so we need a 230 volt emergency bus bar. For that, we again have an 440 to 230 volt step down transformers. Okay, so how many transformers we have total? We have two main transformer and we have two emergency transformers. So this 440 volt is stepped down to 220 volt emergency switchboard. And from there it is connected to various 230 volt emergency consumers. Okay, so right now you got a very clear idea about how four generators are connected and how the electrical distribution of a ship. There are four generators, there are four transformers, and there we got a lot of bus bars. How these bus bars are connected. Now I think it's very simple for you guys. So next time I will show you guys, I will take you guys for a tour to the ECR. I will show you what all equipments are connected. I will show you guys how the main switchboard is connected. So in that section, I will show you clearly the generator breakers, and I will make another video of emergency switchboard section. So this is just an outline, just how the single line diagram, how we can read a single line diagram, okay? Okay, so my next video, I will come up with much better videos. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.